We are now broadcasting in the BBC music programme a performance recorded at Sadler's Wells Theatre of Mozart's opera The Marriage of Figaro. The libretto by Lorenzo da Ponte, based on the play by Beaumarchais, will be sung in the English version by Edward J. Dent. And the conductor, Charles Mackerras, has made some adjustments to the vocal lines in accordance with Mozart's original text and with the performance practice of his time. This is the cast in order of singing. Figaro, the Count's valet, Donald McIntyre. Susanna, the Countess's maid, Elizabeth Harwood. Dr. Bartolo, Noel Mangin. Marcellina, his housekeeper, Rita Hunter. Cherubino, a page, Anne Pashley. Count Almaviva, Raimund Herincx. Don Basilio, a music teacher, John Fryatt. Countess Almaviva, Arva June. Antonio the gardener, Eric Stannard. Barbarina, his daughter, Sheila Amit. And Don Curzio, a notary, Stanley Bevan. With the Sadler's Wells chorus, chorus master John Barker, and orchestra leader John Seeley. The opera is conducted by Charles Mackerras and produced by John Blatchley. Thank you.
foot. That makes 6 foot. Just 6 foot three.
Yes, I think it's most becoming. Just the sort of head for me. Just the sort of head for me.
Oh,
oh, look here, my darling Figaro.
Figaro.
Oh, look here, my darling Figaro.
Oh, look here, my
darling
Figaro.
Look here, look at the grass for me.
That makes 6 foot.
You think my hat is lovely.
Just 6 foot three.
Look here, my darling Figaro. Don't you think my hat is lovely? Don't you think my hat is lovely?
Yes, I'm sure it's illusion nicely. Just the hat I'd like to see. Just the hat I'd like to see.
But do look here.
Yes, it suits you.
Do look here.
It suits you nicely.
Yes, I think it's most becoming.
Yes, I'm sure it's most becoming. Just the hat I'd like to see.
Thank you.
What is your secret?
His noble lordship finds his turn of hunting all the country for amorous adventures, so he means to come home now in the hope of a new one. But it is not the Countess, let me tell you, that his lordship is after.
Who is it this time?
Why, your dear little son.
What, you?
Oh, the very same, sir. And you can see now how useful he will find it. If he gives us a rumor, I'm his neighbor.
Bravo! And what's the next thing?
Now you can understand the real meaning of the gracious protection that he shows us.
I do indeed. How very altruistic.
That's not all. There's more to tell you. Don Basilio, who teaches me singing, is in the club too, and loses no occasion to inform me of this at every lesson.
What?
Basilio! Oh, the scoundrel!
But do you suppose that my lord gave me a dowry just to reward your service?
I had flattered myself so.
Oh, no, he gave it to buy from me that ill-established privilege which the lord of the manor...
Privilege? Has not the lord himself abolished it forever?
He has, but he regrets it, and he would like to buy it back again from me.
Would he? I like that. That's what I call a nobleman. He does just as he likes. I think you'll find it. Who's ringing? It's the Countess.
Then I must leave you. Goodbye, Figaro, darling.
We'll hold our own against them.
Keep your wits about you.
I thank your lordship kindly. Now I'm beginning to understand all this mystery. And to appreciate your most generous intentions. And so to London, you ambassador, I first courier, and my Susanna. Confidential attaché. No, I'm hanged as he does. Figaro knows better. If you are after a little amusement, if you are after a little amusement, you may go dancing, I'll play the tune. You may go dancing, I'll play the tune, yes. I'll play the tune, yes. I'll play the tune. I'll teach your lordship steps and deportment. New kinds of favors you shall learn soon. I'll teach your lordship steps and deportment. New kinds of favors you shall learn soon, yes. You shall learn soon, yes. You shall learn soon. You shall, you shall, you shall, you shall, you shall, oh, never, 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 never doubt it. But in my own way, I'll set about it. I've got my plan. Try to deceive me, I'll do the same thing. To clap at you, yes, to believe me, I'll put a spoke in your wheel if I can, yes, if I can. Try to deceive me, I'll do the same thing. To clap at you, yes, to believe me, I'll put a spoke in your wheel if I can. I'll put a spoke in your wheel if I can. I'll put a spoke in your wheel if I can. Yes, if I can, yes, if I can.
But why on earth did you wait until the morning of the wedding to consult me on this matter?
I can assure you I don't mean to give in yet. It takes very little to break up an engagement, even later than this time. I've got my contract signed and sealed by Figaro, and I'll see that he fulfills it. Our plan must be to frighten Susanna, make her reject his lordship's advances to save her reputation. Then out of the pique against her, he'll be sure to take my part, and Figaro will have to marry me then.
Well, well, I'll do what I can if you will tell me how the case stands precisely. Would be a good joke to saddle Figaro with my Marcellina, since he once stole from me my Rosina. Now for vengeance. Ah, now for vengeance.
Thank you.
Susanna, what has happened, you seem all in a flutter.
My lord, I beg your pardon, but supposing someone saw you, think of my reputation.
Just a word and I leave you. Listen.
My lord, I dare not.
Just one moment. You know the king has appointed me ambassador to London. That means, of course, that Figaro must go with me.
My lord, I beg you.
Ask me, my dearest. You know the privilege that you can command. For life, I am your servant. What would you command me?
My lord, pray let me go. To claim that privilege is the last thing I can wish for. You make me rich.
And, oh, Susanna, I want to make you happy, for you know how I love you. Did not Basilio give you my message? Then listen, won't you spare me a moment sometime this evening and meet me in the garden? For such a favor, you know I'd give you.
Lord, I've just got up.
Who spoke then?
Oh, heavens!
To go prevent him entering.
I'll leave you alone here.
With me, lady, perhaps. I'll ask.
I'll hide behind that chair.
Oh, no, don't
be quiet! And don't let him stay here.
What next? I wonder.
Susanna, heaven bless you. I came to ask if you'd seen his lordship.
And then what should I know about his lordship? Pray go away, sir.
Wait a moment. I tell you, Figaro wants to find him.
Indeed, sir. To find the man who, after you, almost hates him.
I hear now how he serves me.
No, you are wrong. It does not always follow that he who loves a man's wife should hate the lady's husband. My lord, in fact, adores you.
How dare you come to me, sir, with these vile propositions? I will not listen to your talk of his lordship, his passions, and his desires.
Oh, there's no harm done. 'Tis a matter of taste, ma'am. Yet I confess I imagine that like every other woman you would choose for a lover, one who's noble and rich and quite discreet too, instead of yielding to a page boy.
To Cherubino?
Yes, Cherubino. Cherubin d'amore, who earlier this morning was prowling at your door trying to enter.
What a slander! All of your own inventing!
Is it slander with you to keep one's eyes open? And what about that song too? Tell me between ourselves now. I need not tell you that I never repeat things. Was it for you or for me, lady?
Why did he pick up this then?
Apropos, my dear girl, it would be wise just to warn him. You've no idea how he gloats upon the Countess when he's waiting at table. If me lord were to notice, well, need I tell you, on that point she's quite a savage.
Oh, you monster! You are always inventing lies and spreading them around.
Oh, you wrong me. All I did was to tell you what everyone is saying. I've added nothing to it.
Well, sir, what is everyone saying?
Delightful.
How disgraceful. Go at once, sir. Find the scoundrel and drive him hence. Go at once, find the scoundrel and drive him hence.
My intrusion brought confusion. Pray forgive me, I meant no offense.
Oh, dreadful, I'm ruined. In the terror and suspense.
Go at once, go at once, sir.
Intrusion.
Oh, I just don't find him hence.
Pray forgive me, I meant.
I'm ruined.
What shall we do?
What shall we do?
Come, my dear, sit down a moment.
Oh, where am I? Let me go!
Truth.
What he told you is the truth. It is the truth. forgive him.
I forgive him. I forgive him. I know more of him than you.
How so?
What?
Sir?
Really? Tell us how.
'Twas only yesterday. I chanced to visit Barbarina. The door was locked, but when she opened it, I thought her rather flurried. This aroused my suspicions, so I looked in every corner, and then gently, gently lifting from the table the cloth upon it, Cherubino. What have you against her? For himself, then.
And he shall hear to yes, Richard.
One moment. Are you so brazen? What will you tell him when your guilt is so obvious?
I've done nothing that I need be ashamed of.
When did he come in here, then?
He was already here when you made your entrance. He came to ask me if I would make her ladyship to intercede for him. Your coming in put us both in confusion, and he made for the nearest place to hide in.
But I sat down myself here as soon as I came into the room.
I was hiding behind while you sat here, sir.
And when I went behind you...
Then I crept around the chair and hid inside it.
Madame, then I suppose he's heard every word I said to you.
I did the best I could, sir, not to listen.
Yes, you're right, dear.
Be careful, sir. Someone's coming.
And will you sit there still, you little viper? Susanna and I are to be married. So, may it please you, since by your grace I receive her as a virtuous bride, to place with your own hands upon her head this symbol of virtue.
That's devilish clever.
I'll not be taken in. My friends, I thank you for your loyal devotion. It was only my duty to reform these abuses, and I deserve no praise for having abolished what offended alike virtue and nature.
Eva, Eva, Eva!
Here's justice, and so I promise that I'll perform that ceremony. I ask your brief indulgence. I purpose that all my faithful subjects shall see with what splendor we shall celebrate your nuptials. I must find Marcellina. Now go, good people! Susanna! I took them by surprise then. Well, gallant captain, you're forgetting that I'm here.
Before you go, I have something to tell you.
Goodbye, goodbye, Master Cherubino. How your destiny changes in one brief moment. Say goodbye now to pastime and play, lad. Say goodbye to your airs and your graces. Here's an end to the life that was given. Here's an end to your games with the girls. Here's an end to the life that was given. Here's an end to your games with the girls. Not for you the ribbons and laces. Not for you frills and feathers and favors. Pink and white like a girl's so all your faces. You must lose all those ringlets and curls. You must lose all those ringlets and curls. Not for you, but frills and feathers, curls and ringlets, airs and graces, and sweet pretty faces. Say goodbye now to pastime and play, lad. Say goodbye to your airs and your graces. Here's an end to the life that was given. Here's an end to your games with the girls. Here's an end to your romps in the haven. Here's an end to your games with the girls. Chest drawn out and shoulders back, sir. Hold your head up, that's the slack, sir. Take your musket on your shoulder. That's the right style for a soldier. You depose you for death or glory. As to pay, that's another story. Quite another story. Quite another story. No more dances now, but training for the pleasures of campaigning. Yes, you find it quite exciting. When you come to see some fighting, bugles calling, sabers flashing, cannons roaring, waters crashing, headlong into danger dashing, bullets whistling past your ear. Not for you, buffaloes and feathers. Not for you, trousers and ringlets, not for you. Airs and graces, not for you. A sweet, pretty fair. Say goodbye now to pastime and play, lad. Say goodbye to your airs and your graces. Here's an end to the life that one day, lad. Here's an end to your games with the girls. Here's an end to your ups in the hay, lad. Here's an end to your games with the girls. Someday you'll come back victorious. If you don't get killed before, then you'll swear that war is glorious. For a glorious thing is war. For a glorious thing is war. For a glorious thing is war.
Thank you.
lady anxious.
And there is no cause for that, ma'am. It is quite a simple matter. His noble lordship looks on my bride with favor and thinks that he can buy back in secret that old privilege of the lord of the manor. You see, it's very possible and very natural.
Possible and natural?
Perfectly natural. And if Susanna's willing, perfectly possible.
Stanley, now you're talking.
I've done already. That was why he decided to take me to London as courier and to choose Susanna, confidential attaché to the embassy. And because she persistently refuses the diplomatic post which she was offered, he threatens now to side with Marcellina. Now you know the whole story.
Have you the heart to speak of this so lightly? It is a serious matter.
Aren't you thankful that I can take it so lightly? Hear what I've done now. I have sent by Basilio an anonymous letter to warn Milord about an assignation to be given during the ball to a lover by Milady.
Oh, heavens, how could you? To a man who is so jealous.
So much the better. That makes it easier still to set him wondering, to harass him, to embroil him, to upset all his projects, to fill him with suspicion, to make him realize that the game he is playing is a game other people can play upon him too. We'll make him waste all the day in search of the culprit. And then, all of a sudden, before his noble lordship can interfere with our design, he will find us getting married. And then I think he'll see that opposition would be useless.
Maybe. But you are reckoning without Marcellina.
One moment. I have it. We'll let his lordship know that he can meet you this evening in the garden. We'll dress up Cherubino.
I took good care that he should not depart yet.
Dress him up as a woman and send him to the garden to keep your appointment. In the midst of all this, Milady arrives. Milord is caught red-handed and will thus be completely at her mercy.
Will this do pretty well? I hope it may then, when once he's laid his mind off. What is the time now?
You can just do it nicely. My lord's out hunting. Won't be back for some time yet. I'll go now and send Cherubino directly. I leave you to look after his disguising.
And then,
oh, if me lord out got a little amusement, he may go dancing. I'll play the tune, yes. I'll play the tune, yes. I'll play the tune.
Cherubino heard all the things that his lordship said this morning. You can't imagine. Why did the boy go to you then and not to me at the first day? And where's that song he's written? Here it is. And when he comes in, we'll make him sing it. But now was nothing. I thought so. Come in, sir. Forward march, gallant captain. Oh, do not call me by such a hateful title. For it reminds me how soon I must be parted from her. So kind and gentle, yes, and so lovely is love. She is lovely. And he meant it. Make haste and sing the song now that you gave me this morning. Let our ladyship hear it. Who wrote the song? Who wrote it? You needn't ask him when he's blushing all over. Take my guitar, Susanna, and play it for him. Tremble with emotion, but if my lady wishes, she does indeed, she does. Don't keep her waiting.
Take
Indeed, ma'am.
Am I?
Someone's inside there.
Who do you think it is, then?
That only you can tell me. I've only just come in here.
Ah, yes. Susanna, of course.
But you told me Susanna went to her own room.
Either to her room or mine, I did not notice.
In that case, what is the reason I find you so perturbed, ma'am?
On account of my maid.
That's as it may be, but you are perturbed, ma'am.
I think it's you, milord, that are so perturbed about my maid.
Perhaps you are right, ma'am, and I will show you the reason. Come out, Susanna. Come out, at once, I say.
No, where is Cherubino? She can't give away. She can't give away.
Why can't she leave the baby? Why?
Reason,
a man did I know, 'tis all to be the reason.
raising your voice then. Susanna, if you are there.
Unlock that door, ma'am, or must I have it closed?
I beseech you, do not fear me all. Do you mean that you really could believe me untrue?
Just as you please, ma'am. I mean to see at once who is shut in that room.
Yes, you shall see him. But do be calm and listen.
Then it is not Susanna.
No, there's somebody else there, one with harmless intentions you no right to suspect. I was preparing for this evening's amusement a harmless piece of fooling, and I will swear that my to rule for my own.
Who is it? Tell me! I'll have his blood.
Oh, listen. I cannot speak.
I'm listening.
Child. Yes, Cherubino.
Am I condemned to find him? Is him of mischief everywhere I turn? What's this? He is not gone yet. All is clear now. This explains your confusion, all my suspicions. Now I can understand this anonymous letter. How to
come, no more concealment, all to come and all to go.
Do not hurt him, I beseech you. He knows what you know, he knows that you know, he knows that you know.
Would you still be interfering? Would you still be interfering?
No, but me.
Well, go on then.
No, but me.
Well, go on then. Go on then. Go on then.
He's innocent, I swear it. Yes, yes, I swear it. When you see him, oh, don't be angry. In his shirt sleeves, without a collar.
In his shirt sleeves, without a collar. Yes, go on then.
To dress him as a lady.
Dress him up, indeed, milady. I give him a dressing up.
Oh, do you want to?
Dressing up, indeed, milady. I give him a dressing down. Where's that key man? Where's that key man? Tell me nothing. Go from hence, for I renounce you, and as faithless I denounce you. Go forever, my good king. You've disgraced my house and name. I can't find a soul, and yet
Susanna.
Where the world is large and narrow.
O my lord, O my lady, look here. What is all this about? What has happened? Just to let you know, I'm gonna see him. Just to let you know, I'm gonna see him. Every day from the window they throw down all their rubbish and up to the gardens. But was never so bad as today, sir. But just now they have thrown out a man
from that window.
Smashed my geranium into the gardens.
Yes. Oh,
what can this mean?
This is most inconvenient.
Well, I'm here. Of the man that you saw, where is he now? Ran away when he did quick as lightning. Ran away, but I can't tell you where. I know for his own. Stop the noise. What did you say? Stop the noise. What is it? What I say? How can we believe what you say when you're drunk at this hour of the day?
Let me hear the story, criminal.
A man from that window.
From that window.
Into the garden.
Into the garden.
Take no notice, criminal.
Now continue. Now continue. You didn't see his face.
That I did not.
No, I did not. Oh, you marvelous fool, to be quiet. What a fuss for a couple of flowers. If you want them to know who the man was, who jumped down from the window, twas I. Who jumped down from the window, twas I. Oh, twas you then.
I knew you'd save us.
Oh, twas you then.
I knew you'd save us.
Great white heart, I cannot believe it. When you grow with eviction, you'll fall. I cannot believe it. I cannot. Oh, I would swear you were just harmless.
That teacher did not stand in your time.
Lord
of all things. Does he still contradict you?
What do you say?
What I've already sworn, sir.
Cherubino!
Now we're ruined. Now we're ruined.
Why, of course, Sir Cherubino. Then he must have returned here on horseback. For today he went off to the town. Though I'm sure that he was not on horseback. For no horse from the window came down.
Be patient. No more of this nonsense.
So t'was you. Yes, t'was I.
Hence if I hear of you, fear of me.
Once like this, sir, I was waiting in there for the thunder when I heard such a babel of voices. Yours was angry. I thought of this letter. So I jumped from the window in terror. And I twisted my foot in my foot.
I suppose that this paper which I picked up
is yours.
I have it now.
Now he's done for me. Now he's done for me.
Sharpen your wits, man. Sharpen your wits, man.
Tell me now what this paper can be. Wait a moment. This paper. I've so many, I should think it's a list of your creditors.
Of the wine shops politely.
Come tell me, you can leave us now.
Leave us now.
And quickly, just you wait till I catch you up.
Yes, sir.
You can do what you like, I don't
care. Yes, sir.
Just you wait till I catch you up.
Yes, sir.
Well, sir. Well, sir. I'm waiting. All my memory, all my memory. Of course, the condition which the boy left a few hours ago. What was that for? It's needed.
It's seeming.
Come tell me. Well, it's usual. Come on to me quick, sir.
Where is
something that's not so good?
omit these interruptions. Let them state their case to me. Let them state their case to me.
This man here has signed a contract to his fulfilling an application that the country fulfilled.
What's this? A contract?
I must have silence, have silence, have silence. Tis for me to judge this case.
I appear before this lady as her counsel in this action for performance of the contract and for damages in full.
Once more I tell you, be silent, be silent. Tis for me to judge this case.
I bear witness that the plaintiff lent him money on condition that he would not repay her, he to marry her.
No more, the contract shall now be laid over, and the truth I myself will discover. All in order shall now proceed.
Here, the future was the problem.
What about us we expire?
This watch is just a habit.
We'll so make them both
decline.
The
inside the dressing room with my lady so embarrassed. A man who jumps into the garden from the window, and then another who tells me that he did. What on earth can it mean? Could it have been some young man of my dependence? There is no limit to what they will dare. But then the Countess, I must not insult her. She has too high a sense of her dignity and of my honor. My honor. Human nature is frail, I must admit it.
There, don't be sorry, don't tell him you're making him in the
mud. I wonder if Cherubino ever went to Seville. I told Basilio to find out about it.
But man of him, Figaro,
don't say a word to Figaro. This publication shall be kept by myself.
Before this evening, Basilio should be back.
Oh, my lady, I'm able to remember all our happiness.
Susanna. Who knows? She may have told the Countess all I said to her. Oh, if she has done, Figaro shall marry that old Marilyn.
Marcellina! Milord!
And what do you want?
Milord, have I offended you?
Come, tell me, what's your business?
Milord, my lady sent to me. She has her usual vapors and desires you would lend her your smelling bottle.
Pray, take it.
I'll bring it back soon.
No, no, pray, keep it. You may need it yourself.
Myself? Girls in my position don't have ailments of that sort.
Not even a girl who lost a bridegroom and are before the wedding.
We'll pay off Marcellina with the dowry that you so kindly promised.
You say I promised. When, pray?
I thought I understood so.
Yes, if you've been inclined to come to an understanding.
If that is all, sir, I hope I know my duty for your lordship.
Oh, why are you so cruel?
Supposing he paid Marcellina. He paid her. How could he do it? Besides, Antonio refused to let Susanna marry Figaro, a farming who knows nothing of his parents. I shall flatter the old idiot, although he's never sober. This is all in my favor.
My pride, my pride, my pride. decided. The barrier will pay her. That's what the gutter code says.
So I'm happy.
And I'm wretched.
At last, the man I love will have to marry me.
I lodge an appeal, my lord. The judgment is a just one. You must pay her or marry her. Bravo, Don Curzio.
Your lordship's humble servant.
Tis a very sound judgment.
You think it sound, sir?
Yes, for we're all avenged now.
I'll never marry her.
Oh, yes, you will, sir.
You must marry her or pay her. Did she not lend you 2,000 silver pounds, sir?
I am a nobleman, and I cannot marry without the consent of my parents.
Of your parents? Where are they?
I wish someone would find them. For the last 10 years, I've been looking for them everywhere.
Still, you were found on the doorstep.
No, but lost there, I think. Or rather, stolen.
Stolen? Your proofs, sir.
Documentary.
Proofs? Yes, indeed, sir. The fine embroidered clothing. Yes, and the jewels and the gold, too, found me by the robbers when they stole me. What better proof is wanted of my birth and my breeding? And in addition, here on my arm, a very curious birthmark.
What? A strawberry mark on your right arm.
And how did you know?
Oh, heavens, 'tis him.
'Tis I, indeed, ma'am.
Oh, oh.
Raphael.
By robbers, you were stolen.
Yes, near a castle.
Behold, your mother.
My nursemaid.
No, your mother.
His mother.
What can this mean?
Heavens, your heart! For my long-lost child, and greatly let your father hold you.
Father dear, now I have found you. Don't refuse to do the same. Conscience tells me I'm your father, and you now shall bear my name.
He's his father.
I'm astounded.
She's his mother.
I'm confounded.
Then the card
I'm lost is mine.
I'm your father.
I'm your
she's mother.
I'm astounded. I'm your father.
Wait a moment. Here I have the money ready. I will play the fine for Peter.
my mother who says it is true. My father who says it is so shall repent. It's the joy shall be filled. It's the soul shall repent. It's the joy shall be filled. It's the joy shall be filled.
He be here still when he ought by this time to be in Seville.
Excuse me, sir, but today Seville's at my house. There they pressed him at the grocer, and there he's left all his other clothes behind.
The devil he has!
Come with me, and you'll see for yourself, sir.
Oh, my lady, write what I tell you. I give me your flowers. Look how she blushes. Susanna, doesn't she remind you just a little bit of someone? The very image.
Caught you at last, sir. Here is the gallant captain. Well, milady.
I do assure your lordship I'm just as surprised and annoyed as you are.
But this morning?
And this morning, I admit we intended to dress him up in girl's clothes as you see him, to make some fun this evening.
What are you doing here?
My lord.
You shall be punished for not obeying orders.
Please, your lordship, please, your lordship. You so often have said to me when you came to see me, and hugged and kissed me. Barbarina, if you love me, I'll give you all you ask for.
Did I say that?
Oh, now give me Cherubino to be my little husband, and I love you just like my little kitten. Me lord, I think it's your turn.
Good little girl, you're pretty smart at picking up your lessons.
Is it a plot of man, woman, or devil that puts me in the wrong at every moment?
My lord, if you keep all these girls here waiting for nothing, we shall not have any dancing.
Indeed. With your injured foot, you think of dancing.
I don't feel it much now.
Come, girls, the music's waiting.
How will we ever finish your skate?
We sure did, sir.
Yes, it was lucky you only damaged the flower pots.
You're quite right, sir. Now come along, girls, make haste there.
And so Cherubino got on his horse and galloped off to Seville.
I then galloped or trotted. Well, good luck to him.
Now, girls, we must be moving. And Cherubino lets his commission in your pocket.
Yes, he did, sir. I can't think why you ask me.
No good you're making signals. He cannot read them. Well, here is a young man who says my future nephew is a liar.
Cherubino.
Yes, that's him.
And what does he say?
That it was he who jumped down onto the window this morning onto the flower beds.
Does he say so? Well then, if I could jump it, he is lighter than I am. Couldn't he do the same?
You both jumped.
Why not?
I should not think of calling him a liar.
Mark the music.
Away now.
Come take your places. You girls, let take your places.
You take my arm, Susanna.
Here I am.
This is shameless.
Oh, how I tremble.
Milady.
Praise him, O Mozart. Here come the two happy couples. We must receive them now. Besides, there's one bride under your protection. Be seated.
I will, Mom. I plan revenge upon them.
Thank you.
his soup there. His lordship pricked his finger. Now see, he has dropped the pin and cannot find it. This evening, the marriage of these two happy couples in a right merry fashion. It is my wish that the night shall pass in feasting. We'll have dancing and singing. After supper, there'll be fireworks. I mean to show you the reward that I give for faithful service.
It was used, wasn't it, to steal a letter? I know as much as you do.
If you know as much as I, why do you ask me?
I should like you to tell me how his lordship sent you on such an errand.
He just said to me, "Here, Barbarina, take this pin and give it to the lovely Susanna and say to her this is the seal of the pine wood."
The pine wood.
But I forgot he told me, "Don't let anyone see you." But you will not tell I told you.
Oh, you can trust me. I know. Of course not.
Goodbye. I must be going. First to Susanna, and then to Cherubino.
Mother!
Fair.
I'm ruined.
I would have called it coming.
here.
My life is ruined.
Patience, patience, all my patience. I know it's serious and requires careful thought. But to begin with, you do not know who's going to be the victim.
I do indeed, though. Why, Mother? That is the pin that he picked up in the ballroom.
I know, but this is no more than a warning that you must watch them and keep your eyes wide open. Still, you cannot be certain.
Yes, I will watch them. And thanks to Barbarina, I shall know where to find them.
Tell me where you're going.
To avenge myself and the whole race of husbands.
Quick, get me one, Susanna. I'm sure she is innocent. She's so natural, so modest, and so candid. And then besides, supposing she isn't. Well, now that I've no reason to be jealous any longer, surely all women ought to support one another when we think how we're treated by our husbands and lovers. Oh, 'tis our duty.
Thank you. come here. Here we are.
Why are you scowling just like a villain in a play? What is the cause of this mysterious appointment?
You'll see very shortly. You're invited here to witness the ancient privilege of the Lord of the Manor, granted by my virtuous bride.
Oh, shall we really? I see now how it stands. They've arranged it without employing me.
You stay here and wait where no one can see you. I have to go and make further arrangements. I'll come back in a moment. Then, when I whistle, you all rush out together.
The man's possessed by devil.
What has upset him?
Nothing. His lordship likes Susanna. He has given him tonight an assignation which Figaro does not like.
But do you think he ought to suffer it in silence?
Many a man has endured it. Why should he make objections? And then consider, if he did, where's the gain? For in this world, friends, to cross swords with the gentry is a dangerous pastime. And in 90% of cases, you'll be defeated. Youth is headstrong, overbearing, to impulse in airs or rule. I myself was young and daring, I was just as big a fool. I was just as big a fool. But the passing years have brought me sense enough to swallow pride, and experience at last has taught me not to swim against the tide, not to swim against the tide. One fine day I met a fairy. You may think I am romancing. She drew near me like a fairy, and with graceful step advancing, threw me something rough and hairy, rough and hairy, rough and hairy. Saying, take this gift and wear it. You won't regret it. Then she vanished into air, left me with an ass's skin. Then as I gazed at it, silent in wonder, gazed at it, silent in wonder, a flash of lightning came, loud roared the thunder, and then the rain began. It nearly drowned me, it nearly drowned me. I had no shelter, coat or umbrella, only the donkey's hide lay there nearby. I slipped it over me, it kept me dry. The storm was over soon and up I started. Some horrid animal straight at me darted. Its eyes were gleaming, its chops were steaming, and to defend myself, how could I try? How could I try? How could I try? All of a sudden the beast turned bumpkin, smelling of a donkey's hide. It was revolted, it lost its appetite, it lost its appetite, and ran away, and ran away. Take this advice, my friend, and learn this lesson. Scandal, calumny, affliction, oppression will never penetrate the donkey's hide. Scandal or calumny, affliction, oppression will never penetrate a donkey's hide. Will never penetrate a donkey's hide. Will never penetrate.
I hear footsteps. Susanna! Not a soul! Darkness infernal! So I begin this evening to learn the wretched trade that it is to be a husband. A traitress to deceive me on the day of our wedding. I saw him read her letter. I saw him laugh too. Laugh myself, little knowing what I laughed at. Oh, Susanna, Susanna, have you brought me to this then? Those eyes so sweet and candid, and that face so ingenuous. Who would not have believed them? Oh, he would trust a woman, full and full again. Yes, fools you are and will be, so still your eyes are opened, until you learn what women are, and know them true and true, and know them true and true, and know them, and know them true and true. Yes, you may call them angels, but one day you'll awaken with faith that's surely shaken. You'll find it far from true. You'll find it far from true. You'll find it far from true. They charm us with witchery to waste us away. Like tigers, they fascinate to make us their prey. Their meteors that dazzle us and blind us. The silent lures of till on the rocks we find us. You trust them for one day, the next they deceive you. They love you on Sunday, on Monday they leave you for coaxing and crying, cajoling and cheating and cheating in life. They cannot be beaten. The mercy they show, the mercy they show. No, 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 no. Yes, fools you are and will be. Fools till your eyes are opened, until you learn what women are and know them through and through, through and through, through and through. They charm us with witchery, the rest will pass over. Like tigers they fascinate, the rest will pass over. Their silence will lure us on, the rest will pass over. Their meteors that dazzle us, the rest will pass over. You trust them for one day, the next they deceive you. They love you on Sunday, on Monday they leave you for cooking and crying, cajoling and cheating and cheating and lying. They cannot be beaten. The mercy they show, the mercy they show. No, no, no.
His lordship, his Princess Susanna. your ladyship shall see them. For now the trap is set, yes, now the trap is set, yes, now the trap is set.
You speak so loudly, I need no explanation. Yes, the fences I'll have to, yes, the fences I'll have to.
Susanna, you said vengeance.
Yes.
Vengeance? What need have you of vengeance?
I mean to set the trap
for set the trap for me.
Yes.
I'll help you do it's true.
I need
to set a trap for me. I see what she will do. What she will do. I see what she will do. Ah, oh, if the lady desires.
I see it is already.
Oh, me, lady.
So now we have a love scene.
Here at your feet, me lady. I burn with warm emotion. Accept my adoration. See how you were betrayed.
Now is the time to punish him.
Oh, how my bosom swells with love.
I long to box his ears.
A fury counterfeits.
I'm a standard master. Cherubino, my daughter, my mother, the Countess, the plot is discovered, the traitress is here, the traitress is here.
Forgive me, forgive me.
No, no, I denounce you.
Forgive her, forgive her.
No, no, I denounce you.
Forgive her.
No.
Forgive her.
No.
Forgive her.
No, 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 no.
End of Mozart's opera, The Marriage of Figaro, which was sung in the translation by Edward J. Dent and recorded in Sadler's Wells Theatre. This was the cast. Figaro, Donald McIntyre. Susanna, Elizabeth Harwood. The Countess, Arva Joan. The Count, Raimund Herincx. Cherubino, Anne Pashley. Dr. Bartolo, Noel Mangin. Marcellina, Rita Hunter. Don Basilio, John Fryatt. Don Curzio, the lawyer, Stanley Bevan. Antonio, the gardener, Eric Stannard. Barbarina, Sheila Amit. With the Sadler's Wells Chorus, Chorus Master John Barker, and Orchestra, leader John Seeley. And conducted by Charles Mackerras, who prepared the version which was used.